Hello students, welcome to Narayana online classes. Day 5, chemistry assignment, class 7th, topic chemical bonding. So next question is, what is the electronic structures of Na2S? Here sodium is the metal, atomic number will be 11, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. And sodium sulfur, it is a non-metal, atomic number 16, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. So in case of the sulfur, 6 valence electrons, in case of the sodium, 1 valence electrons. Suppose here, coming to here, 2 sodium atoms and 1 sulfur atoms. Each sodium atom contains the 1 valence electrons. The sulfur contains the 6 valence electrons. Okay, sodium is the metallic in nature. It contributes the donate the electron to sulfur. So sodium lost the electron. Then as a result, what you get here? Sodium carries the positive charge. Total how many sodium atoms here? Sodium ions here? 2 ions. And sulfur gains the 2 electrons from the 2 sodium atoms. So sulfur octet is completed. Sodium octet is also completed. Between these ions, electrostatic force is present. So if you write the formula, 2 sodium atoms and 1 sulfur atom, the charge of the sulfur is -2, charge of the sodium is +1. So 2 sodium atoms, the total positive charge will be 2 units, total negative charge will be 2 units. So finally we will write the formula like this, Na2S. Second question is, write the electronic structure of calcium sulfide. So 100% ionic bond is present, because calcium is the metal and your sulfur is the non-metal. Coming to the atomic number of calcium, 20, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Coming to the atomic number of sulfur, 16, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. Sorry, I wrote here 3s2. 3p6 and 4s2. In outermost 2 electrons there, here in the outermost 6 electrons there. So because of the metallic character, calcium lost the 2 electrons to get the octet configuration. Sulfur gained the 2 electrons from calcium to complete the octet configuration in the outermost shell. Next, see here, calcium 2 valence electrons, sulfur 6 valence electrons. So your calcium lost the 2 electrons and donated to sulfur. Then it becomes Ca plus 2 and sulfur with 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which carrying the negative charge. Between the cation and anion, an electrostatic force exists. Nothing but electrovalent bond or ionic bond. So simply we can write the formula as a Cas. Total positive charge 2 units, total negative charge 2 units. Our third question is, write the electronic structures of aluminium fluoride. Same ionic bond, aluminium is the metal, here fluorine is the non-metal. Coming to atomic number of aluminium, 13, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1. So in outermost 3 electrons are there. Coming to the fluorine, atomic number 9, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. So in outermost 7 electrons there. So aluminum try to lost the 3 electrons. Each fluorine try to get the 1 electrons to complete their octet configuration. Now see here, aluminium having the 3 valence electrons. Aluminium having the 3 valence electrons. And each fluorine, 7 valence electrons. Each total 3 fluorine atoms, each floor will have the 7 valence electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then each fluorine atom gets the 1-1 electron from aluminium to complete their octet configuration. As a result, aluminium acquires the plus 3 charge and each fluorine acquires the unit negative charge. Between this cation and anion, electrostatic force exists. Your total positive charge will be 3 units and total negative charge will be 3 units. Minus 1 plus minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So finally, we will write the formula like this, AlF3. Last question or fourth question is, explain the electronic structure of calcium hydride. It is also ionic compound. Your hydrogen is a non-metal, calcium is a metal. So coming to the answer, calcium is a metal, your hydrogen is the non-metal. Atomic number of calcium 20, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. So in outermost 2 electrons are there. In case of the hydrogen, atomic number 1, configuration 1s1. So only 1 electron is present. Your hydrogen can't get the octet configuration. It can get the only helium configuration, nothing but duplet configuration. So hydrogen ready to get the 1 electron, calcium ready to lose the 2 electrons. So see here, calcium having the 2 valence electrons and each hydrogen has the only 1 valence electron. Next, here calcium donate the 2 electron to 2 hydrogen atoms. As a result, calcium get the unit, dipolar charge, and each hydrogen atom get the negative charge because of the gain of electron. Writing this side and this one. So between the cation and anion, electrostatic force of attraction present. As a result, we can write the formula like this. 2 hydrogen atoms, 1 calcium atom. Total positive charge is 2 units. Total negative charge is 2 units.